Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Cooking with Dimple. Today in my channel I will show you a jackfruit recipe. In Bengali it is called Echor. I will use prawns in this dish, but if you want you can omit prawns and make it in a veg form. You can make in a pure veg form if you omit garlic and onions. But this jackfruit I love to cook with onions and garlic like we do in mutton. And today I'm adding prawns to make the taste delicious and yummy. And here you can use any type of prawns. If you have the small prawns, tiger prawns, or any medium sized prawns, you can use any of them. Needed to make Echor chingri. So these are the main ingredients. This is Echor, which means raw jackfruit. So Echor chingri means raw jackfruit curry. And I'm using potatoes. It goes very well with this jackfruit curry. So these are potatoes. Here I have used 4 diced potatoes cut into small pieces so that it gets nicely fried. Echor cleaned and chopped into small pieces. So I'll pressure cook this so you don't have to worry whether it's cooked or not. It gets cooked. Onions, 4 onions chopped. I'm using prawns, but if you want to make in a vegetarian form, no need to add prawns. If you omit that, it becomes a vegetarian version. So, but I'm using prawns. So this is almost 50 to 100 grams of prawns used here. It depends upon you whether you want to use more prawns or less prawns. We just need the flavor of it. It goes very well with this Echor. So prawns, these are the small prawns which you get. 1 tomato diced, ginger and garlic, 12 to 15 garlic cloves, ginger, and 2 green chilies for that nice chili paste. So these are the main ingredients. So now let us see the masala we require for this. 6 spices we require for most of our cooking. So for tempering, we will require here cumin seeds, cinnamon sticks, few green cardamom, cloves, split whole red chilies, bay leaf. These are the basic whole spices for tempering. So, and these are the dry spices which we require: garam masala powder, turmeric powder, red chili powder, coriander powder, cumin powder. So these are the basic spices. So you can see the spices are very less, and the cooking will be done in mustard oil. Salt and sugar to taste. The first thing I'll do is I will make a paste of ginger, garlic and green chilies, and I'll keep that aside. Paste ginger garlic is ready. Mustard oil gives a nice punch to this recipe. It tastes much better. 1 tablespoon, 2 tablespoons of mustard oil. And first thing, I will fry the jackfruit and the potatoes with salt and turmeric powder. So add the jackfruits first. Teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. And now fry them till it changes its color. Again added 2 tablespoons of mustard oil. And now these whole spices like cumin seeds, green cardamom cloves, cinnamon sticks, whole red chilies, bay leaf goes for tempering. Now add the oil. This dish is mainly prepared like a mutton recipe. Onions are nicely browned. Now I'll add tomatoes. I want my tomatoes to get nicely fried. If you fry the tomatoes well, it doesn't have that watery taste. So before adding ginger and garlic, fry this for a couple of minutes or till it changes its texture a bit. Onions always fry it till brown so that it gives a very nice color to your curry. So that is a tip. Now add ginger, garlic and green chili paste. Saute this till the raw smell of the garlic is no more. So if you want you can add little bit of water so that it doesn't burn. I'll add little water. So water here, I have poured this in this jar so that all the remaining portion also is used. And now saute this for at least 2 to 3 minutes till the raw smell of the garlic is gone. Get cooked till the raw smell is gone. So now I have seen there is no more raw smell. So first dry spice I'll add is turmeric powder and cumin powder. Two teaspoons of turmeric powder. And 2 teaspoons of cumin powder. The reason for adding spices at different times because cumin powder has a strong smell. So I want that smell to get mixed with the paste first. So, and turmeric powder, a lot of people do a mistake. What they do, they add turmeric powder later on and the raw smell of the turmeric doesn't taste good in your curry. So first thing, always remember, turmeric powder goes in and cumin powder and garam masala goes at last. So same way I will add little water and continue to stir so that the spices do not burn. After stirring this for at least a minute, after that I will add red chili powder and coriander powder. As because in this curry, cumin powder has a special part in it, a special role, the flavor of it. So I have added this at first because the amount used is more. It's 2 tablespoons, 2 teaspoons. Now I'll add 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. And 2 teaspoons of red chili powder. Again add little bit of water. Water helps your spices to get nicely mixed and sauteed. Otherwise it might burn. And burnt taste of spice doesn't taste good in your curry. So, and second thing, I'm using a pan in which it doesn't stick. If it sticks, it comes out very nicely. So you can also use a non-stick pan. I will add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. During this time your flame will be medium. In my induction I'm using 180 for that stir fry mode. Now I'll add the prawns. The reason for adding the prawns right now is that I want to just saute it for few seconds. I've not fried it before. You can do that if you want to fry it in separate pan and keep that and use later on. You can do that. But I'm frying with the spices so that all the aroma and the juice from the prawns goes inside this paste. I want to have that flavor. Now add the jackfruit and the potatoes. Now continue to stir and coat this well with spices. You can check your seasoning. Lot of people add sugar. If you like, you can add, but I avoid sugar in most of my curries, but it's your preference. Like in Bengalis people, lot of people love to use sugar, so it's no harm, they can use if they like. So in medium flame, let's saute this with the spices so that everything gets coated well. Now I'll add garam masala powder. So all the spices like cumin, seeds, coriander and garam masala powder, everything is homemade. So I make them at home. So every 15 days I ground my spices and keep it in a jar. I like to do that because my mom used to make a paste with those seeds. She used to soak the seeds for at least half an hour and then used to make a paste in the mortar and paste, that pestle they used to, that silbutta which they called. So nowadays we have the mixer, so it's more easy. So you can just make dry masalas and keep. So it is nicely coated and sauteed well. Now I'll pressure cook this. So I have to take out a pressure cooker and I'll pressure cook this till at least 2 whistles. Add little water, and if you want little semi-thick gravy, then you add water. So I'll keep my dish semi-thick so that you can eat with rice. So just you need to warm. The water is warm. I will just add this in the curry, in the jackfruit. So now I'll close the lid and pressure cook it till 2 whistles. So I'll cool this off and then open. Be very careful while opening your pressure cooker lid. You can see this echo chingri is ready. It looks like this. It is semi-thick. So now I'll serve this in white bowl. You can serve this with rice, parathas, puris. It tastes so good. So enjoy this during summers, because after summer you do not get this jackfruit. It's a very popular dish in with Bengalis. They love to eat echo. So please do try. I have served this in white bowl. It looks beautiful. You can see the prawns inside. So small prawns has a strong flavor. So in this type of curry, you can use the small ones. So friends, hope you like this recipe. Do try this and let me know in my comment section to share with your friends. Thank you in advance for watching. Happy cooking.